According to residents, random shots were heard launched in the congested residential area of Leslie Land just after 8 p.m. Tuesday. Within minutes of the incident, the lifeless body of Ulanda Frederick, better known as Jordan, was found by police riddled with bullets. News that Frederick was killed spread like wildfire, and the crime scene later turned into a mourning place for family members.
I just saw her lying down, you know, with grass in her head and things, so, and holes, bullet wounds, you know, in her head. It's a sad thing. That's my family, my sister's child, you know, and you know the way she is, you know, I like her a lot, but she was never bad to me, to us. But then, you know, I used to hear she used to be in crossfire with people, confrontation with different people, you know, gang-related things.
Family members say that when Ulanda was born, doctors said she was a girl, even though they say she carried features of both genders. According to her grandfather, she was sent to school with girls' uniforms and also dressed in girls' clothing. However, as time moved on, she became someone different, and the gender issue became a bitter issue for his granddaughter.
I think that had her very miserable, because when she knew she was a boy and everybody was treating her as a girl, she, and wearing a dress, and she went to that school, Maricil, she kept on behaving like, you know, very bad.
Ulanda Frederick's grandfather says that Ulanda had a lot of respect for her family. Ulanda was raised with her grandparents and is the second of her mother's three children. The day following the incident, crime detectives returned to the scene to search for more clues. A box of cigarettes left after the shooting incident, apparently in the hands of the victim before falling to the ground. For the DBS News World, I am Cecile Actille.